And that's a fight. It's a boxing ring that political parties have reduced the politics of relief to. Was this necessary? Is the Congress apprehensive about Modi's gains? Is Mr. Modi or the BJP apprehensive about Sonia Gandhi flagging off, a relief campaign? Does it really matter who brought the relief? Is it possible that every single packet of relief can be depoliticized, or is it too difficult to ask politicians to do that? On the News Hour tonight, Shazia Elmi of the Aam Aadmi Party, Sunil Jakhar is top Congress leader of the opposition in Punjab, Sanjay Bapna, former secretary of the AICC, All India Congress Committee, is from Jaipur. The BJP is represented by Nirmala Sitharaman and a BJP member Asifa Khan from Gujarat, for the perspective from Gujarat, because there's been some criticism of Mr. Modi. There's a feeling that there's too much hype around Modi's relief efforts. But my first question goes to Artosh Singh Bal, a senior journalist and political editor of The Open magazine. Now, can you single out either side, Artosh, or are both sides responsible for this fight? And how do you think the people of India are going to view it?
No, I think both parties in equal measure are responsible for this kind of feeding of a tragedy. I mean, this is like vultures gathering at a carcass. This is a time when the country should be focused on making sure every person, that includes locals from the state and pilgrims who are there, are provided relief. Any VIP, any chief minister, any head of a party is a distraction. They contribute nothing to the effort. There is no reason we should be reading or hearing about them or hearing party state charges about who has done what.
So you're saying Modi should not have gone there himself?
There was no reason for Modi to go there himself. Why did we need to see Modi in that state? If he had to provide help, let him provide the help. Let local conditions decide how that help is to be used. And if the help is meant for pilgrims, let it be decided how it is to be used.
Precisely.
Why do people have to go show their faces?
Well, precisely. Same question. And Nirmala Sitharaman, I'll come to you. But same question can be asked to the Congress party. Sunil Jakhar, we've seen Sonia Gandhi flagging off relief campaigns. You know, now, why does anyone need to flag off relief and rehabilitation to victims? If the Congress party is helping or anyone is helping, you don't need the cameras out there. It's not a motorsport race. Why don't you just send the relief? Why have a big photo opportunity around it? So the Congress party is doing the same thing. Why, Mr. Jakhar? To take credit?
First of all, if there's any credit to be had of this tragedy, I think it belongs to our armed forces and to our security forces, who have done their best there. And I think time and again they have proven their worth. Whenever we are faced with any situation like this, it is they who come to the rescue. And I think there is nobody else who can claim any credit for it, and there is no credit to be had. As far as visiting that area, I think as a leader of the people, I believe you have reporters there, and what they report from the ground is different than what you and I sitting here in air-conditioned offices or our homes can have a view. As a Prime Minister or as a UPA chairperson or even a Chief Minister, going there and getting a first-hand view is okay as long as...
No, but why should... Why should this argument be made? And on this, let's get the second Congress representative. Then I go to the BJP representatives in just a minute. But Sanjay Bapna, if I were to ask you, why should this argument be made that, you know, if you want to help, you're going to have to help through the Uttarakhand government? Does it matter what it's taken through? Who it's rooted through? Or is there a growing sense of insecurity, Mr. Bapna, that suppose Narendra Modi makes two more sorties, or as a newspaper described, the Rambo effort of Narendra Modi is making some people insecure? Let Modi help? Let a communist government help? Let a Congress government help? Let them help in whichever way they want? Let NGOs help? Let business houses help? Why do you necessarily want everything rooted through your government? Is it because you're worried about political credit being taken by your rivals? Why should there be any political color to help?
Are you finished?
I'm waiting for your answer. Yes, I am, sir.
Yeah. Okay, so first of all, like Mr. Jakhar, I appreciate and thank the armed forces of the country for whatever they are doing in Uttarakhand to provide relief. And always, whenever there has been a calamity in the country, they have been always there. And we are, as citizens of this country, we are all thankful to them. As far as any relief providing is concerned, and any political party or anyone taking credit for the same is concerned, is first of all, and you know, criticizing political parties becomes very easy. First thing is, why do we have to have this kind of a debate on the channels? You know, the moment you stop covering all these and you stop having these kind of debates,
Mr. Bapna,
which really don't matter.
Mr. Bapna, you see, because I'll tell you why. No, I'll tell you why. I'll tell you why, and let me give you a very straight reason why. Because, Ajay, 1 minute, please allow me. Mr. Bapna. I do not believe that we can live in a fictitious world where I can pretend that your leader said nothing. Your leader, Ajay Makan, said, people of this country are very keenly watching how personal ambitions of a politician in Narendra Modi can make him use such words which would demotivate the armed forces and mar the relief operations. Many of his utterances, particularly those references to national security, should have been avoided at a juncture when our army is saving lives of people in Uttarakhand. This will demotivate them, people who are supposed to be single-mindedly pursuing relief operations in Uttarakhand. That's one. Then Digvijay Singh says, Modi is using the media to push his own interests. Modi is taking credit for people already evacuated by the administration and the army. So simple answer to your question, Mr. Bapna, is this, that this is a debate that you started. Your leaders have said it.
No.
Right? You are not answering my question.
No.
One second. The question was simple, and this is relevant to you. Why can't the Congress leaders, like the BJP leaders, why can't both the Congress and the BJP for once donate and help anonymously? Why does Modi need to go? Why does Sonia Gandhi need to flag off a rally? Applies to both. Why?
You see, if one starts it off, the other will definitely rebound it. And even if the other party does not want to, you know, media will not leave without a reaction. You know, the moment media stops, you know, if you feel that there is an issue on which a political party is trying to take undue benefit, why do you have to telecast
it? Let me tell you that for the last 8 days, and I genuinely believe right now that the political party's degree of discomfort with the media is at an all-time high. Because for the last 8 days, the politicians have been dodging, ducking, and running away from cameras when they are asked, why was there no meeting of the disaster management authorities? Why were these projects cleared in the way that they were? Why was no explanation given for the projects on ecological grounds? Why was the CAG not listened to? Why were the warnings not taken care of? Why is the National Disaster Management Authority, which I'm told had its first meeting today, such a walking, talking disaster itself? You don't want to answer those questions. So, Mr. Bapna, what you do is you target the media. Then we ask you why you're politicizing it. Then you want to target the media. I think it's a very shallow line of argument, sir, that you are pursuing. I'd now like to go across to Shazia Elmi. Let's get all points of view in, Mr. Bapna.
I'm sorry, Mr.
Shazia Elmi.
You have got all the questions and all the answers.
No,
and you don't let anyone else speak. Mr. Bapna,
I have, you know, I would now like to remind you, since you are very interested in pursuing that line of argument, that do you think the Uttarakhand Chief Minister is making a mistake by ascribing which money or which state government contributes money? Do you think it is a mistake or not?
Any kind of disaster, oh God.
Mr. Bapna, if you finished with your expressions, please answer the question.
You see, the question is, I don't know when you are going to end. So now that you have ended, the question is that any person or the government wanting to help in a disaster should be welcome, irrespective of whether it is the Chief Minister or the Prime Minister or a district collector or anyone. A single person wants to help with a rupee, he should be welcomed.
Excellent. Now I'd like to get in. If you finished, Mr. Bapna, which I presume and hope that you have, I hope that you now will let Shazia Elmi come in.
Thank you.
Ms. Shazia Elmi, Sanjay Bapna takes a strange position given the fact that his own political party wants to ensure that all the money is routed through the Uttarakhand government. I want you to respond to what he's saying. Nirmala Sitharaman coming to you right after that.
I think it's really unfortunate that all the politicians want to do right now is blow their own trumpet at this point of time, and I want to remind them that all the innocents who have died and all the common people who are stuck there are far bigger than BJP and Congress. And I really think this country and its innocent people, just ordinary people, are far more important than the agenda of BJP and Congress too. I would also like to remind all of them, whether it's Narendra Modi or the various CMs of the Congress, that they're not paratroopers, they're not ecologists, they're not conservationists, they have never done sorties in their lives before, they have never done rescue operations, they're not technical experts. Why on earth would they be going there, wasting taxpayers' money? And I would also like to add a point that all the relief operations that they're talking about and want to take credit and they want to flag off or want to do aerial surveys, which will yield no results whatsoever.
Yes.
But just to indulge in
scoring
political brownie points,
precisely.
I would like to ask them, there's a lot of money.
But
it's
precisely,
a lot of money, it's taxpayers'
but it's,
money.
But it's very interesting, Shazia, that it's very interesting, Shazia, isn't it? That Mr. Sanjay Bapna, who I think is a Congress leader, former Secretary ICC, has completely taken on his own party's state government, which says individual efforts of state governments are hampering the rescue effort. Mr. Bapna thinks the Uttarakhand government is wrong.
I thought
you just said that all parties, irrespective. You want to change your position?
I never said that.
You want to roll back the tape?
Mr. Arnab, yeah, sure. I said any person, individual, or any other state government wanting to help,
yes,
should be welcomed.
Well,
that is what I have said.
Precisely. Yes. And that's what your state government is not
wanting
saying.
Wanting to help is one thing, but using it as a photo op. See, wanting to help makes sense and you should help and do all that you can, but using it as a photo opportunity to gain brownie points and to, you know, to make it one-upmanship as a motto. And because they're past masters, you see, of this double speak and, you know, political opportunism. But they don't know, they're not technical experts.
The question is tonight to the BJP, therefore.
The taxpayers' money and...
The question, therefore, goes to the BJP. Manoj, I'm coming to you. But I think many questions have been asked to the BJP. It should be their turn. Ms. Nirmala Sitharaman, the point being made by some of our panelists is this, that it's not about the right of any state to contribute in relief work, but about making a media campaign out of it that seems to have rankled many.
Yeah.
What people seem to be more concerned about is the media campaign, the description of this, you know, as a Rambo act, the fanfare surrounding the relief. And there is a view, Ms. Nirmala Sitharaman, that given the experience of the Kosi incident, when Narendra Modi had 5 crore rupees returned to him by Nitish Kumar, when he tried to help for the flood victims in Bihar, and an attempt was made, some people thought at taking credit of it. The feeling is that maybe it would have been better if Mr. Modi was more low profile this time.
First of all, let me tell you that the BJP has taken a very constructive position as regards what we want to do in the Uttarakhand, national calamity, that we call it as a national calamity. The president of the party, Rajnath Ji, had already announced that all our political programs will be standing cancelled and our concentration would be on the relief operations, whether you collect, you know, materials which are required from wherever you are and to send it to Uttarakhand, or any other way, but all of us should focus on relief was something which our president announced even on the 18th. And subsequently, all of us are focusing on it. Then the second step came when all the MPs committed a month's salary towards the relief operations. That has also been followed up. And third, we've all been very clear that from every state, all of us will participate in some way or the other in the relief activity. So we are not just talking about, you know, where the cameras are going. We are talking about things which are concrete and required. Now, if about chief ministers going there to help their people or any others who are going to come together with that, every chief minister, because they are answerable to their respective people, will take a step in this kind of a disaster and not wait for an opportune time and permission from a state government saying, can I please come? I want to rescue our people.